So previously we saw that we could replicate a source sheet by using what are called source panels, where instead of having an entire sheet where we need to integrate along this an equation that looked like this, we were able to put panels along that sheet and replicate the strength of that by these straight panels. And so we're going to do the same thing with the vortex sheet. We're going to find that it's useful to be able to replicate a continuous vortex sheet by simply a series of straight panels of vorticity. So the mathematics simplifies significantly, so that, in general, we would need to integrate this equation numerically in order to find the velocity at some point induced by this vortex sheet here. But if we use panels, these discrete panels, the mathematics simplifies significantly, and then we can increase the number of panels to increase the what we call the grid resolution. And in the limit, as the number of panels go to infinity, then we would get back the influence of that the vortex sheet. Okay, so let's work through that briefly here. So we're going to say that we have a vortex panel now. And we'll say that it's lying on the x-axis. So that's going to be a panel that has a continuous distribution of these line vortices. So we've got x and y, and we want to look at the influence of that vortex panel on some point, pxy. We're going to integrate over dx naught to keep that separate from the x coordinate. Dx naught will be our variable of integration. And we've got r here, that's our radial coordinate from that location, x naught, which is x naught comma 0, out to the point xy of interest. Okay, and so we can plug these simplifications into this equation here, what we'll get there is that vx, the velocity in the x direction at that xy point, is equal to y over 2 pi integral from x naught equals 0 up to L of gamma x naught over x minus x naught squared plus y squared dx naught. And vy at xy is equal to minus 1 over 2 pi, the integral of x naught equals 0 up to L of x minus x naught gamma of x naught over x minus x naught squared plus y squared. And we're integrating in dx naught. Okay, so these equations are good for this panel, and it can have any distribution of vorticity. We've still got this gamma. Remember, gamma is the strength of that panel as a function of x naught. So we haven't made any assumptions about how the strength of that vorticity varies with x location. So we can plug in any function that we want there, and sometimes you assume that that strength is constant, in which case gamma is just a constant, it's independent of x naught, it can be pulled out of the integrand here. In our case, we're going to assume that it's a linear variation. So that means that we're going to have a gamma 1 at this end of the panel and a gamma 2 at that end. And we're going to assume that gamma varies linearly. And so the function for gamma of x naught will be gamma 1 minus x naught over L times gamma 1 minus gamma 2. Okay, so that's just a function that shows us that that gamma is varying linearly across that panel. And so we can plug that in, again, into these two equations here for gamma, and get out an expression for the velocity in the x direction and the velocity in the y direction for any panel, any vortex panel, that varies linearly in strength. And what we get is 1 over 2 pi L times, I'm going to again write this in matrix form. What we get here in the top left is L minus x times capital phi plus y times psi. And in the top right, we get x capital phi minus y psi. In the bottom left, we get y phi minus L minus x times psi minus L. And in the bottom right, we're going to get minus y phi minus x psi plus L. And that matrix is multiplied by gamma 1 and gamma 2. So it's directly, it's a proportionality constant multiplied by the strength, gamma 1 and gamma 2. And we need to define capital phi, which is A tan 2. Again, we need to preserve the quadrant of that xy location. So it's A tan 2 of yl and y squared plus x squared minus xl. And capital psi is equal to 1/2 times the natural log of x squared plus y squared over x minus l squared plus y squared. Okay, so this is the equation for the velocity induced by a vortex panel on any point, PXY. But what we've assumed is that panel is straight. That's the definition of a panel. It's just a straight line. And we've assumed that it varies linearly from gamma 1 to gamma 2, varies linearly in strength from gamma 1 to gamma 2.